As we all know, the stress we experience going through the changes of menopause can have detrimental effects on our emotional health. But what about our physical health? Can the stress we experience in this midlife transition be causing us panic attacks? That's today on Second Act TV. Jean, welcome back. Thank you for joining us again on another episode focused on emotional health.
Yes.
The last time you were here, we discussed just the importance of getting our emotional health in check as we go through all these major changes. Because if you don't, there could be some pretty devastating issues down the road. Talk about that.
Well, one of the things that can happen that is very surprising to people mm-hmm. is panic attacks. Mm-hmm. Oftentimes, people believe that panic attacks are some kind of coping mechanism for ill people or weak people, and it starts at a young time of mm. life. The fact is, it can happen to anyone at any time of life. It can be a result of a trauma. It can be a result of hormonal changes. It can be a result of life changes, physical problems. Mm-hmm. My first panic attacks happened to me in my mid-50s.
So you have panic attacks.
So I went through that, and it was a very
scary.
Humbling and scary experience mm-hmm. for somebody who treated people for that mm-hmm. for many years, and finding, wow, this isn't so simple. It is a very scary thing. And for me, it was when the rug got pulled out from under me when I was widowed. But it can happen for many different reasons. Mm-hmm. And the important thing to keep in mind is that there is help. Panic attacks are highly treatable, often with just a short course of therapy. And yes, sometimes medication, don't be afraid to take that. It can mm-hmm. be very useful.
Yeah. Well, as you know, when we talked off camera, I too went through that. And that's why we feel that this is a message we really want to get out there. So what are some of the classic symptoms and some of the classic solutions that anybody watching us, can do?
Well, first of all, one of the things is a very intense feeling of anxiety, panic, unable mm-hmm. to cope with the situation. It's not just having the nerves, having the jitters. It can feel overwhelming, and it's at a time where there's no actual stressor going on at that moment that would seem to justify
that. So you don't relate.
It can just come out of mm-hmm. nowhere. And you can be trembling, sweating. It can feel like your heart is about to bounce out of your chest. You can be nauseous. You can feel faint, dizzy. Sometimes people do faint. Sometimes people wind up in the emergency room. They think mm-hmm. they're having a heart attack. And it can be extremely scary. But it's important to know that if it is a panic attack, you're not going to have a heart attack, and that you can talk yourself down from that. You can learn some techniques, which I teach in my practice all the time, cognitive behavioral therapy.
What does that mean, cognitive behavior?
It means learning how to change the way you think. Basically,
Okay. Changing
your thoughts, how you talk to yourself, what it is you're telling yourself about what's going on around you. It's
okay.
not just what you're feeling, it's how you're interpreting what's happening about you, what you're telling yourself about that feeling.
Okay.
So if your heart starts to beat fast and you say, oh my God, I'm having a panic attack, I think I'm going to die, then you're going to get worse. If you tell yourself, mm-hmm. I'm having a panic attack, but I know what to do to get down from this, you're going to start to feel calmer. So you learn how to talk to yourself. You learn some relaxation techniques. Hypnotherapy is one that I used a lot in my
mm-hmm.
practice. There are many things you can do. And yes, again, medication can be useful as well.
Yeah, I'm not a big proponent of it, but that one, yes.
Yeah, in that case,
I understand. And that's great. Great advice. Yeah, no,
And there's some very specific techniques for that that can be really useful that you can do with a therapist.
Mm-hmm. Jean, thank you. That's really, really great and important information. And again, if you feel like, you can identify with what you've heard here today, go to our website. We'll be posting some additional resources that can give you some insight into what a panic attack is and why we now at 50 are even prevalent to get them again. Thanks for joining us.